Right, this morning I got to melt up about 80 grams of 9-carat alloy gold, and I thought it might be interesting for those of you who haven't done this or have never seen it done. This is an ingot we made yesterday, and in fact it cracked, and we were forging it, which is the first step in processing a cast ingot, and you can see it's got a very strong crystalline structure. I suspect it was because of the zinc that I added right at the last minute. You add zinc to some gold alloys to strengthen the yellow color. So the 9-carat alloys tend to be quite reddish because there's a lot of copper. So we can balance that by using a little bit of zinc. In the trade, when I was an apprentice, we would use brass, but it's hard to know exactly how much zinc you're adding. So this morning I'm going to be using actual zinc, and of course it's very volatile. It melts very readily and produces a big puff of bluish white smoke, which is not particularly great to inhale loads of. So you do that right at the end, and about 15 to 20% of the zinc will burn off. So you could calculate, but what we do is we allow for that to burn off, and what it means is the gold alloy consequently is ever so slightly higher than 9-carat. We like this color. It worked really beautifully when we remelted the bit that broke off. So we're making some more. So in the crucible here, we have copper, gold, and fine silver. So that's pure gold, pure silver, and pure electrical copper, in the correct proportions to give us the same alloy, less the zinc. So I'm now going to proceed. What I have to do now is warm up the ingot mold. This is a bar mold. This is one that somebody machined for me when I was an apprentice. It's important to warm it up so that when you pour molten metal into it, it doesn't get a shock and freeze too suddenly or sputter or whatever. I'm going to warm it up, and then I'm going to take a little piece of leather and stick it in where I estimate the gold will fill to give me a nice, reasonable, evenly distributed ingot. I think it's going to be right here. It's about 80 grams, so an ingot about that long. This is for two bangles, in fact. So that's what I'm going to do next. The torches will be on, so it'll be a bit noisy, so perhaps you won't hear me. So I'm going to warm that up, pop that in, put some oil in just before I pour. I'm going to melt the alloy. You'll see me pop the zinc in, a big puff of white smoke, very alchemical. And then, all going well, we'll have a little ingot shortly. Want to burn my fingers,
No.
is all. Okay, I think that's all right. Thank you. a bit of oxide on the surface. So I've got some borax on hand. Once I think the metal's all molten, because the copper, you really need to make sure that does melt and diffuse throughout. There's no need to stir things like this because the metal, the atoms are moving so rapidly, Brownian motion. Everything's mixed pretty well. I think it's all molten, so pop in some borax to clean off the scum. Now this is a 300 job, so I'm going to have to ask my trusty camera woman to drop the zinc in for me in a moment. There's going to be a puff of smoke. Okay, pop it to one side. Okay, come on. And in we go. That's a pretty fat ingot. Could have given it a bit more room. Perhaps we'll melt it again and do that. And you can see the white bloom. That's the zinc. But the ingot itself looks pretty good. So while it's in place, I'm going to move the little stopper. See all this excess. I want to make sure we have a longer piece of gold. Over here, perhaps. All right, so the ingot casts very nicely. You can see it's got a nice structure, nice and smooth, but it's a little bit like an overfilled loaf of bread. So it needs a little bit more space. So I've moved the stopper down here. This is all still very, very hot. So the ingot will fill properly next time, and it'll be a nice, even cross-section. We were looking for sort of a square section, so we work it down, the metal is worked evenly. So I'm going to put that back in the crucible, remelt it, and this time we're going to try with these green welding goggles so that you can see a little bit more. So it's a bit of an experiment. Bella's literally going to just hold this in front of the camera, so everything's going to go green in a moment. When I get up to heat. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. All right, don't want to hang around. It's all molten. A little bit of borax. A little bit of oil in the mold. Let's do this. A little bit of flux. That's solidified. That's okay. There it is, nicely cast. That tinkling is both the cooling of the crucible, the flux in the crucible. I feel it ought to have some kind of poetic name, the song of the crucible or something. the song of the sweaty crucible. So the alloy, it came in the first instance, Bella had it from an old goldsmith in the Birmingham Jewellery Quarter, but I had the same alloy from an older source, George G's old manual from 1909, the Goldsmith's Handbook. So this alloy has been around for at least 100 years, but you can see the colour. It's not a bad colour for an Ankara, and it works really nicely. That's a good ingot. That's going to forge out really rather well. And we'll show you the forging later. All right, for those of you interested in this particular alloy composition, 37.6% gold, that's AU, 10.3% silver, AG, 44.4% copper, and 7.7% zinc, ZN. And this is a 9-carat alloy, and that was about 80 grams.